AZ of Outlander, everything you need to know about the hit TV show. America. Outlander is set largely in 18th century Scotland, with brief interludes in France and Jamaica. But as Series 4 gets underway, the action shifts to colonial North Carolina. The latest installment was still filmed on this side of the Atlantic, however, with some early scenes shot last year at Grey Buchanan Park in Polmont, which was transformed into a graveyard. Other locations used include Abercorny Estates near Crieff, New Hale's house in Musselburgh, B. Craig's Country Park near Linlithgow, Cumbernauld Glen, St. Andrew's in the Square in Glasgow, Abercorn Church near South Queensferry and Caldergillen Country Park in East Kilbride. Books. Based on the best-selling books by U.S. author Diana Gabaldon, Outlander charts the adventures of former combat nurse Claire Fraser, née Randall, who, during the second honeymoon to Scotland with her husband Frank in 1945, is transported back to 1743 through a mysterious set of standing stones. On the brink of the last Jacobite rising, she meets dashing Highlander Jamie Fraser and their powerful story as star-crossed lovers unfolds. Gabaldon's debut Outlander novel, first published as Cross Stitch in the UK, hit bookshelves in 1991, and the 8-book series has since sold more than 28 million copies. There is a 9th, Go Tell the Bees That I Am Gone, in the pipeline. Claire Fraser. Leading Lady Claire Fraser is played by Irish actor and former model Katrina Balfe. The time-traveling Claire is headstrong and forthright, with a knack for getting herself into trouble due to an unwillingness to sit back and watch injustice unfold. She served as a nurse on the battlefields of France during the Second World War and is an amateur botanist, skills which come in handy when navigating life in the 18th century Scottish Highlands. Fun fact, Balfe was cast only days before Outlander started shooting in 2013. Executive producer Ronald D. Moore said it came down to the wire as they sought to find the perfect Claire. Costumes. Cheese graters, blow torches, sandpaper, industrial spray guns and pumice stones are among the arsenal of tools used to give Outlanders costumes their aged, lived-in look. Costume designer Terry Dressbach has been the woman at the helm since the television series came into development in 2013. Her ethos has always been to make every item worn by the cast, from leading characters to extras, as authentic and accurate to the era as possible. That included ensuring the British Army redcoat uniforms were the perfect shade, a deeper, richer red rather than a bright cherry, candy apple red, and sourcing 50,000 buttons from around the world to avoid the zip debacles that have befallen many a period drama. Outlander showrunner Ronald D. Moore, known for his work on Star Trek and Battlestar Galactica, is married to Dressbach, and it was her who introduced him to the books. Dressbach, who has worked on Buffy the Vampire Slayer and The Shield, fell in love with Gabaldon's novels more than 20 years ago, stumbling across the books while looking for something to read between film jobs. Series 4 will be her last, with Dressbach citing family and health reasons for departing the show. Eagle-eyed fans have noticed that Nina Ayres, who previously worked on Outlander as an assistant costume designer, is listed alongside Dressbach on the Series 4 credits. Cumbernauld. Many of the show's interiors are shot at Ward Park Studios in Cumbernauld, a former factory that has been converted into a production base with 4 state-of-the-art sound stages. When Outlander is filming, the hangar-like space is home to elaborate sets. In recent years it has seen everything from an apothecary shop to cobbled Parisian courtyards, as well as an armory and departments dedicated to props, art, decor and costumes. Doctor Who. Diana Gabaldon drew inspiration from another time-traveling series, Doctor Who. In an episode from the late 1960s, Patrick Troughton encountered a Scotsman from 1745. The young man Jamie McCrimmon was wearing a kilt, which Gabaldon thought was rather fetching. It was this which inspired Outlander's leading man Jamie Fraser and her novel's mid-18th century Scottish setting. Gabaldon decided to have an English woman to play off all these kilted Scotsmen, but her female character took over the story and began telling it herself, making smart-ass modern remarks about everything. Voila! The indomitable Claire Beecham Randall Fraser was born. Droughtlander. The Twitter hashtag created by avid Outlander viewers to describe the agonizing stretch between one series ending and the next beginning. Droughtlander is almost over. Series 4 will be available for UK viewers on Prime Video from November 5th.